Welcome back in electronics lecture. We have started the chapter is study of components. In that we have studied all those components which are included in this chapter, that is resistor, capacitor, inductor, how to measure the value of resistor. So we have also seen the capacitor, charging, discharging of capacitor, its equations and examples on that. Okay. Today we are going to see the example on the transformer. In the previous lecture we have seen the transformer, what is transformer, what are the types of transformer that we have seen. Okay. So transformer is used to convert AC current into DC current. Transfer means what? It transfers the signal. Okay. In the transformer there are three types of transformer we have seen. That is what? Yes. Step up transformer, step down transformer and mutual transformer. Okay. So in mutual transformer what happened? Number of turns of the primary winding is equal to number of turns of the secondary windings. Both windings are equal, therefore it is called as a mutual transformer. That winding is indicated by what? NS and NP. Number of turns of the primary and number of turns of the secondary. Okay. Similarly, the voltage across the primary number of turns equal to voltage across the secondary number of turns. That is, voltage means what? Vp and Vs. Similarly, we have seen the current across primary and current across the secondary. But in this, what happened? Current across the secondary is greater than the current across the primary. Okay. So this transformer is nothing but, see the diagram of the transformer is like this. Here AC signal is connected, isn't it? Secondary number of turns where load resistance RL is connected. That everything in detail we have seen in the previous lecture. Just I am reminding you that this AC, this part, this what is the primary part, is connected with this AC signal, and this secondary part, this is the secondary, this is the primary, is connected with the load resistance RL. See, these two are not directly connected to each other, two windings are not directly connected to each other. Then how it is connected? It is connected by the its magnetic field. Magnetic field is produced between these two windings. Because of the magnetic field, it is connected. It is directly not connected to each other. So there are three types of transformer we have seen: step up transformer, step down transformer and mutual transformer. In step up transformer what happened? Number of turns of the secondary is greater than number of turns of the primary, is called as the step up transformer. Similarly, step down transformer is number of turns of the secondary is less than the number of turns of the primary, is called as the secondary transformer. In mutual transformer, both number of turns of primary and secondary are equal. Okay. So these are of made up of so many things that we have seen. That is the air transformer. So next is the air core transformer, ferrite core transformer, isn't it? And iron core transformer. That we have seen what is there in these transformer. In air core transformer, air will be acts as a core. In ferrite core transformer, ferromagnetic material will be acts as a core, and in iron core transformer, iron will be acts as a core, that we have seen in the previous lecture. On the basis of that transformer, we are going to see the examples. Okay. Example is like this. See, if number of turns of the primary is 23 and current across that secondary of the transformer is 4 ampere, then the voltage across the secondary is 100 and voltage across the primary of the transformer is 230, then calculate the IB and NS. IB means what? Current across the primary and current across the secondary. Okay. So how we can solve that? Solution will write, we know that, what we know, that is the number of turns of the secondary of upon number of turns of the primary, which is equal to voltage across secondary is given, is equal to voltage across secondary. See, number of turns of the primary is equal to number of turns of the secondary, which is equal to voltage of the primary is equal to voltage of the secondary. But in current, whatever number of current, secondary current on primary current. Okay, which values are given? Yes, we take these two portion. From that we can calculate the NS. So NS is equal to, yes, see, NP into VS upon VP, isn't it? So what is the value of NP? Is given 23 into what is VS? 100. The value of VP is given is the 230, which is equal to how much? This, yes, 2300 divided by 230. So it is how much? 10. So number of turns of secondary is equal to 10. You can write like this. NS is equal to 10. Then what you have to calculate now? IP. So we can take and write it here. IP you have to calculate. Then you take these two equations. That is NP upon NS is equal to IS upon IP. That IP you have to calculate here. See, IP is equal to this NS cross multiplication into IS divided by NP. This is equal to what is NS that we have calculated is, yes, 10 into IS is given, how much it is? 4. And NP is given is 23, which is equal to 40 upon 23, which is equal to 1.72 ampere. Near about this. Okay. So this is what IP and NS that you have to calculate, these two things. Okay. Next, see what is given. In the next example, turn ratio of 1:7. Turn ratio, how much it is given? Turn ratio is 1:7 and VS is given, that is source voltage is 840 volt and load resistance RL is given, which is how much? 8400 ohm. Then calculate the IS. What is asked? Turn ratio is given 1:7, VS is given, then what we have to calculate is IS. So we have formula, solution you can write like this. Yes, IS is equal to V upon R, that is VS upon RL, isn't it? VS is given, RL is given. So what is the value of VS? It is the 840 volt. And what is the value of RL? It is given 8400. Okay. Then how much is remain? It is 1 upon 10, which is equal to 0.1. I means what? Ampere. Okay. Therefore IS is how much? It is 0.1 ampere. Isn't it? One more formula for IS is, see here what is given, turn ratio is 1:7. We can write it here that secondary current is greater than the primary current. Therefore, this is I, the turn ratio is 1:7 means 1 is for the primary current and 7 is for the secondary current. But in transformer what happens? Secondary number of turns are greater than the primary number of turns. Or in the transformer what happened? In at the time of current, secondary current, that is IS, is greater than the this वोल्टेज फॉर प्राइमरी नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स एंड सेकेंडरी नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स है रिटर्न प्राइमरी एंड सेकेंडरी बट इन द टर्म्स ऑफ करंट सेकेंडरी अपॉन प्राइमरी वी हैव रिटर्न मींस व्हाट इफ इट इज 1:7 देन हाउ मच इट विल बी इट इज अ 7:1 देयरफॉर वी कैन राइट इट हियर इन द फॉर्म ऑफ करंट Therefore, current IS is equal to how much it is S upon IP is equal to 7. Okay. Therefore, IS is equal to 7 into IP is equal to how much it is given? IP is equal to 7 into IS. See this? IP upon IS. We have to calculate what is the IP is equal to 7 into IS. Isn't it? No, IS we have to calculate. The equation is like this. IS upon IP. Therefore, IS is equal to 7 into IP. We have to calculate, isn't it? Here we have to calculate the IS. See, the equation is like this. See, it is IP divided by IS, which is equal to 7. Okay, this is the correct equation. From that equation, we can write like this: IP is equal to 7 into IS. So, IP is equal to what? 7 into that IS we have calculated is the 0.1, which is equal to 0.7 ampere. Okay, so IP is equal to 0.7 ampere. This is one equation. Here we have to calculate the IP because IS is already calculated. IS and IP that we have to calculate in this formula. All of you understand this? Is what is the equation for the transformer that what we have to solve here is the NS we have to calculate with the secondary voltage, primary voltage is given, secondary current is given, primary current we have to calculate here, secondary voltage is given and primary voltage is given. Okay, so this equation is from the transformer. We have seen in the last lecture that NP upon NS is equal to PP upon VS, which is equal to IS upon IP. Similarly, we can calculate the NS. NS is how much it is the 10. Therefore, we can write it here. NS is equal to 10. NS is what? Number of turns of the second. So, there is no unit for that. Okay. So, here NP, we can take these two relations. NP upon NS and IS upon IP. Therefore, IP we can calculate from this formula. Take a snap of that. Then, we will see the next. Next point is what the type of transformer. You have seen the basic types of transformer. There is the step up transformer, step down transformer and mutual transformer. Isn't it? But here the types of transformer, again it is given that transformer means what? Which transfers the signal from one form to the another form. So this transformer is again divided in so many types. That is, first type is the power transformer. Power transformer. What is there in power transformer? High power is used in this transformer. What happens? Every transformer require what? AC signal. Every transformer work on the AC signal. So in this power transformer what happen? AC signal whatever come from the MSCB, that is 230 volt AC is required and 50 hertz frequency is there for the transformer. Okay, So in power transformer, what happened? AC signal is used in the primary of the transformer and 50 hertz frequency is there. And this transformer have only one primary and number of secondary voltages are there. More number of secondary voltages are there in the power transformer. High power is required. Because of the high power, what happened? It has the less resistance. Because of the high power, therefore this transformer are used on the as a high power transformer. It have the more efficiency. Okay, so this power transformer is nothing but which act on the AC of 230 volt and having the frequency is the 50 hertz. These transformer are the more efficient transformer because it have only one winding of primary, but at the second number of turns of the voltage, more number of secondary voltage can be calculated in the high power transformer. Okay, these are used as a high power. Maximum power is used in these transformer. Because of the maximum power, what happened? There is a less resistance. Less resistance means what? What is the function of resistor? Resistor opposes the flow of current. When more number of current is flowing, it will be opposed. So there will be less resistance because of the high power, and these transformers are the more efficient transformer. Therefore, it is the one and first type of the transformer is the high power transformer. Second transformer is the isolation transformer. Isolation means what? No doubt transformer have primary winding and secondary winding, but these two windings are not connected to each other. Therefore, there is no question of electric shock, isn't it? Because these two windings are connected with the magnetic field, not the electric field. Okay. So primary number of turns of winding is required the AC voltage, and secondary number of turns of the transformer is connected with the load resistance. The secondary winding, primary winding is not connected to each other. Therefore, there is no question of what? Electric shock. So in isolation, what happened? Number of turns of the primary is equal to number of turns of the secondary winding. How many number of turns of windings are there in the primary? That much number of turns of the secondary is in the secondary. Of the transformer means what? It should be ratio of 1:1. Okay, so both are the equal. Therefore, there is no question of the electric shock. That is called as the isolation. Isolation means what? Whatever is there in the primary, same is there in the secondary. Okay, number of turns of the primary is equal to number of turns of the secondary. That is 1:1 ratio is there in the isolation. So any direct current can be blocked here. Which comes across the primary of the transformer, blocked by secondary. Any direct current can be blocked by the secondary, which comes at the primary. Therefore, there is no variation of the primary and secondary. Actually, what happened? The primary of the transformer, we connect the AC voltage, and the secondary of the transformer gives some another voltage across that load resistance. Okay, yeah, load resistance across apparently output la varied voltage mitto. That is happened because of the changes of these voltages. But in isolation, what happened? It not allow that changes. It block the voltage whatever it comes at the primary of the transformer. The secondary is blocked. There is the isolation between these two transformer. Isolation means what? Number of turns of the primary is equal to number of turns of the secondary. Okay. Third transformer type is what? It is the auto transformer. Auto transformer. What is auto transformer? Its name says that automatically it changes its stage. That is step up transformer, step down transformer, it changes itself. Means what happen here? Only one winding is there, that is 1 and 3, and centrally connected is the second one. So what happen in this auto transformer, if VP is connected, VP means what? Peak voltage is connected between the 2 and 3 transformer, and VS is connected across this 1 and 3 transformer, then it is called as the step up transformer. It is called as the step up transformer. When what happened? VP is between 2 and 3 and VS is between 1 and 3. Similarly, if it is step down transformer, then what happened? Opposite. Step up transformer is exactly opposite of the step down transformer. So, step down transformer, what happened? If VP is connected between 1 and 3, and VS is connected between 2 and 3, then it is called as the step down transformer. So what happens in auto transformer? Only one winding is there. It is a compact type of transformer. Only one winding is used. Okay. So these are the advantages of this auto transformer. Only one winding is there and this compact type of the transformer. So there are three types of transformer: power transformer, isolation and auto transformer. This auto transformer is its frequency based. It is again have the three types, that is first transformer is it is depend on frequency of the transformer, that is the audio frequency, second is the radio frequency signal, and third type is what? Intermediate frequency transformer. Audio frequency, it is what? Audio frequency transformer. This audio frequency transformer have the range is 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz. Okay, so these are made up of laminated iron core. Okay, laminated iron core is used. In the radio frequency, what happens? It is radio frequency is about 20 kilohertz is there, and ferrite and air will be acts as a core in the radio frequency transformer. All these are the transformer: audio frequency transformer, radio frequency transformer, and intermediate frequency transformer. These are what? It is the receivers. These are what? Receivers. It has its own frequency, that is 455 kilohertz. Okay. So this auto transformer is again divided in three types, that is the audio frequency transformer, radio frequency transformer, and intermediate frequency transformer. So audio frequency is nothing but this is the 20 hertz to 20 kilohertz. Is the range of our hearing frequency. So in this frequency, which transformer is work is called as the audio frequency transformer, and in radio frequency transformer, above 20 kilohertz is the radio frequency transformer, which is covered with the what? The ferrite material, and air core will be its material used in the radio frequency. Last is the intermediate frequency transformer. So in intermediate frequency transformer, it is the RF receivers. These are the radio frequency receivers which have the frequency 455 kHz. So these frequencies are asked in the objectives. So underline these things. So this is the types of transformer. All of you understand this? we have seen in the transformer is what? Power transformer, isolation and auto transformer. Okay, all of you understand this? This is a very simple concept. I will stop it.